Allegiance today will be read by Kyrie Gonzalez, sixth grader at Hernando Middle School.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, ma'am. Let's go down to item number three, superintendent comments.
Yes, President Gandara and members of the board, I'm very proud to share this exciting news with our community that our district received yesterday. As you all know, we launched our WIN Academy to ensure that every single student succeeds in Socorro ISD last year. And we piloted the WIN Academy at 10 campuses. And this year we expanded the WIN Academy to 6 more campuses. So we have a total of 16 schools district-wide that have the WIN Academy. And in order to maintain and expand our WIN Academy, our district has been actively seeking outside funding sources. And yesterday we received an official notice stating that we were approved, Socorro ISD was approved for an $800,000 WIN Academy grant by the prestigious Kellogg Foundation. Yeah. You know, so it's a huge honor for our school district. It's going to benefit our students. Again, $800,000 that is going to be given to Socorro ISD from the Kellogg Foundation. So I want to thank all of our board members for supporting our WIN Academy efforts and working with our team to ensure that no child is left behind. So congratulations to Team SISD. Now at this time, it is my pleasure to welcome new members to our elite SISD leadership team who are with us tonight. So as I stand, please, as I call your name, you stand to be recognized, not as I stand. So first, our new principal at Mission Ridge Elementary, Mr. Jesus Mendez. New assistant principal at Purple Heart Elementary, Ms. Claudia Ruiz. New assistant principal at Mission Early College, Ms. Leslie Goldman. New assistant principal at Paso del Norte, Ms. Hazel Valverde. And new assistant principal at Socorro Middle School, Ms. Irma Ojeda. And we in SISD, we pride ourselves in hiring the best, and I'm sure all the individuals will do an outstanding job in their new roles. Congratulations to all of you. Also, we're looking forward to several upcoming events here this fall semester, and we hope to see many of our students, parents, our community out there on Saturday, this Saturday, October 22nd. We'll have our Career Awareness Showcase at Pebble Hills High School. It's a great event for our young students in 5th, 6th, and 7th grade to learn about the different career pathways that's available in our school district that we offer. Also, on Saturday, this Saturday, October 22nd, at 8 a.m., and it's an all-day thing, so we'll be having our March Fest at the SAC. Our bands, we have some amazing bands. Last Saturday performed. Every single band from Socorro ISD earned a score of a 1, which they will be advancing to area, so they'll be out there again this Saturday. We have some phenomenal talent of our students here that we have in our band. So look forward to seeing them out there. So there's lots of great things. Now this month is National Principals Month, and I know there's some principals here in the audience. So first of all, principals, if you're in the audience, please stand to be recognized. It's National Principals Month. So parents, students, if you see your principal out there, tell them happy National Principals Month. The team made this short little 3-4 minute video recognizing our principals. So if we can show the video at this time.
Hiring of a campus principal is the most important decision that a superintendent makes, in my opinion. that individual will impact everything that takes place there.
Principals are the solid rock of the school, making sure that teachers have the resources so that we're giving everything we need to our students so our students can have that foundation.
But more importantly than anything, the buck stops with the principal. They have to fix the problems. They've got to save the day. They've got to put a Band-Aid on a boo-boo. Their job is to be the principal, but many a times they're cross guard, traffic, EMS, you name it, advocate, lawyer. They have so many roles and so many responsibilities.
It's sometimes a lonely job, as you mentioned, because you make decisions on a global capacity that an assistant principal or a teacher or even a community member, a student, things may not be right. But if success happens, then they see the reasons why.
At the end of the day, the work ethic needs to be there. Without a doubt, it needs to be there, because people understand when you work in SISD as a building principal, it's about people in the day, paperwork in the evening. And I honor the fact that our principals have lives outside of their individual schools and outside of the district. But our principals, they work obviously during the school day, after school, weekends, holidays, it's nonstop. And for that, I thank them so much, because that's what it takes to be a principal. And I'm just a lucky, lucky superintendent. I tell people I'm one of the luckiest superintendents on the planet, that I have the best principals, that our district has the best principals working in SISD, because at the end of the day, I know that each one of our 47 principals, they're making decisions that's in the best interest of our SISD students.
Principals, I just want to say from the bottom of my heart, thank you for your dedication, your commitment, and everything you do to make sure that you take care of all of our students as if they were your very own. Thank you, principals. Happy Principal Appreciation Month.
Principals, from the bottom of my heart, I don't think anybody knows how incredibly hard you work, how much heart you put in to each and every day, and how truly you lose sleep at night for the work that you do. I am super proud to be a part of your team. I thank you, I appreciate you, and for all of those kids, parents, teachers who have never said this to you, on behalf of them, I recognize your hard work and your dedication. Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart, from me to you, thank you.
I want to thank you all for everything that you do. Our students are very lucky to have you as their leader. Our community, our district is very lucky and very thankful that you are the leader that you are. Thank you.
SISD principals, from the bottom of my heart, I thank you so, so much for your efforts and your commitment and dedication to our SISD students. Congratulations on National Principal Month. And thank you so much.
Thank you so much, principals. I know there's several that are not here, but we're going to thank them this week. We have our principals meeting. President Gandara, members of the board, that concludes my comments.
Mr. Gandara, if I may?
Go ahead, sir.
As a follow-up to Dr. Espinosa's report a minute ago, Dr. Espinosa, as always, is more than humble and certainly very modest. Just recently, Mr. Gandara, Mr. Guerra, and I were able to witness their presentation on the Wynn Academy. I think many of you have heard of it, and maybe many of you may be familiar with the Wynn Academy. We were at a conference that was for superintendents and administrators, and I can tell you, sitting in the audience, observing Dr. Espinosa, members of our cabinet that presented and our staff, it was a sense to give our district a tremendous amount of pride in what we're doing here. The Wynn Academy is very successful. To put it succinctly, some of the other sessions might have had some attendance. In the session that Dr. Espinosa and his team presented, they had to bring in extra chairs. And the audience was fully engaged in listening to the presentation. At the end of the presentation, everybody got questions and nobody wanted to leave the room. As a matter of fact, a couple of people kept coming in because there was a session to follow in a little while, but people had very pertinent questions because we had obviously some of our very best staff there to relate that information. It goes without saying that the Kellogg Foundation wouldn't give us $800,000 additional for a project if it didn't work. I think the state has noticed the Wynn Academy. I think being at this conference for all us, obviously the nation has noticed, and it certainly goes a lot to the leadership of Dr. Espinosa, the members of the cabinet, and certainly the teachers and the students involved in the program. So with Mr. Gandara's permission, I'd like to congratulate you, Dr. Espinosa, and your staff.
Real quick, I know I haven't done this and it's been a while, but since we have done it, if you're an active serviceman or woman, or retired, would you please stand?
There you go.
On behalf of the Socorro Independent School District, this board and its trustees, superintendent, we would like to thank you for all your service to this great country. Go to item number 4, board honors. Daniel Escobar.
Good evening, President Gandara, members of the board, and Superintendent Dr. Espinosa. My name is Daniel Escobar, Chief Communications Officer for the district, and it is my pleasure to introduce tonight's recognitions. Our first recognition will honor Team SISD students who were commended in the 2016 National Merit Scholarship Program and who were named 2016 National Hispanic Recognition Program Scholars. Two students earned commended status in the Merit Scholarship Program for their outstanding results on the preliminary SAT National Merit Scholarship Qualifying Test. As commended students, they are eligible to become candidates for special scholarships sponsored by corporations and businesses. Three students earned recognition in the National Hispanic Recognition Program, which was initiated by the College Board to identify outstanding Hispanic high school seniors and share information about these academically well-prepared students with subscribing colleges and universities. The commended students in the 2016 National Merit Scholarship Program are Daniel Gonzalez from Mission Early College High School, the students recognized as National Hispanic Recognition Program Scholars are from Montwood High School, Lydia Cervantes. Isabel Pando. Melanie Murillo. And from Mission Early College High School, Alyssa Gale. Jesus Reyes. And Jennifer Gonzalez. The student counselors are Gustavo Alvarado from Mission Early, and Annette Monsivais from Montwood High School. Students, if you can please have you join your counselors and our board for a photo. Just a quick note while they're gathering for the photo that all of the photos taken by our district photographer, Mr. Largo, will be posted on the district webpage. There's a photo icon on the bottom right-hand corner of our website. It takes you to our Smug Mug account, and all of those photos are available for free high-resolution download. One more. Congratulations once again. Our next recognitions will recognize the winners of the 2016 OAS Challenge. The contest winners promoted their safe and secure learning environments through unique videos, chants, and posters that spread a bully-free message to help create awareness about the issues. Congratulations to the Team SISD OAS Bullying Prevention Contest winners. We'll begin at the elementary level with third place winners from Elfrida Chavez, Jesus Franco. Miranda Lopez. Logan Hand. Alexia Davila. Diego Monares. Josiah Molina. Their Olveas coordinator is Susan Elguea. Second place winners from James Butler, Madison Green. Aaron Madrid. Coordinators are Jennifer Madrid Aguilar and Rosie Rodriguez. The first place winners from Horizon Heights, Itzel Nunez. Seth Brandt. Mia Treviso. Anthony Ortiz. Edgar Garcia. Bianca Hernandez. Navea Matsuda. Elise Alba. Kennedy Kirtley. Nathaniel Lavador. Mylene Deborah. The campus coordinators are Raquel Cox. Rosa Duran. Elena Herrera. Linda Hitter. Melissa Martinez, Jackie Baeza, and Beatriz Valdez. Congratulations once again to all of our elementary winners. All right, if we can have you all work your way to the front for a photo. Octavius, you're good here? Just keep smiling and looking straight. Big smiles, big smiles, big smiles. Keep smiling. We got them all? Congratulations once again. We'll continue with our middle school winners. Third place from Slider Middle, Daniel Gomez. Amir Ferguson. Ariadna Sainz. Diego Ruiz. Angel Anguiano. Their coordinator is Mary Mendoza. Our second place team is from John Enzer Middle, Osvaldo Verdugo, Daniela Lopez. Their coordinator is Joyce Freddy. And our first place winners from Jane Hambrick School, we have Edson Goff, Andrea Andrade, and their campus coordinator is Mr. Ron Reeves. If we can have all of our middle school teams return to the front for a photo. Put Mr. Reeves on top. Keep smiling, keep smiling, keep smiling. Keep looking forward, keep looking forward. Almost there. We get it all. Congratulations once again. Continuing with our winners from the high school division, in third place from America's High School, Rudy Hernandez. And Alan Wasson. Their teacher and coordinator is Andrew Valencia. Our second place team from Socorro High School, Antonio Chavez. Luis Fuentes, Oscar Perez, Armando Veloz, their counselor and coordinator is Connie Campos Reyes, production teachers, Luis Perez. And campus OAS coordinator, Mr. Andrew Halliton. Our first place team is from Montwood High School, Liani Monsivais. John Pereza. Destiny Rosales. Samantha Escandon. Natalia Ramirez. Their production teacher is Mr. Marvin Hanley. And their campus OAS coordinator is Diane Duncan. Can have you all return to the front for a photo with our board and superintendent, please. We got it. Congratulations once again. Next, we have a special presentation in honor of an elementary school counselor who was recognized for raising counseling awareness in the El Paso community. This outstanding member of Team SISD is a recipient of the 2016 Transpecos Counseling Association Community Award. The association, which is a local branch of the Texas Counseling Association, provides resources and effective services to help develop counselors. Congratulations to this dedicated educator from Dr. Sushuk Elementary, Mr. Albert Mendoza. Have you for a photo, Mr. Mendoza. Congratulations once again. Our final special presentation this evening is to recognize a group of Team SISD employees who are celebrating a milestone year in our district. These valuable members of Team SISD have served our district for 25, 30, 35, as many as 40 years. During their tenure in SISD, they have observed the growth of the district in schools and student population. Today, they help us serve more than 46,000 students in 47 campuses across SISD, the second largest school district in the region. We truly appreciate their loyalty, support, and commitment to our students and schools. First, we will recognize the employees with 25 years of service. They joined Team SISD in 1991 when the district had some 14,400 students, 1,700 employees, and only 14 campuses. In 1991, the U.S. postage was 29 cents, and George H.W. Bush was the president. That same year, Apple released the Macintosh System 7.0, and the New York Giants became the Super Bowl 25 champs, beating the Buffalo Bills. The highest grossing films were Terminator 2, Robin Hood, and Beauty and the Beast. Celebrating 25 years of service in SISD, from Montwood High School, Edward Backman. From Helen Ball, Dolores Pretado. From Human Resources, Rudy Campoya. From Slider Middle, Mary Cholka. From Montwood High School, Rose De La Rosa. From John Drugen School, Al Garcia. From Horizon Heights, Jennifer Hansen. From Escondrias, Elizabeth Hardiman. From Eastlake High School, Velsa Mora. From our purchasing department, Maria Morales. From Hernando Middle, Roberto Oliva. From El Dorado High School, Victor Rodriguez. From America's High School, Sandra Rojas. From Slider Middle, Guadalupe Saucedo. From Chester Jordan, Carol Tennyson. And from Walter E. Clark Middle, Cynthia Wilkie. We can have you all please return to the front for a photo with our board and superintendent. Congratulations once again. Next, we will recognize SISD employees who have 30 years with the district. These valuable members joined the team in 1986, when the district had 9 schools, some 8,000 students, and roughly 1,100 employees. In 1986, the U.S. celebrated Dr. Martin Luther King Day for the very first time, Halley's Comet made its first appearance, and Mike Tyson won his first boxing title. The average price of gasoline was 89 cents a gallon. Oh, and Lindsay Lohan and the Olsen twins were born. Celebrating 30 years from Escondrias, Susana Carmona. From Elfida Chavez, Susana Elguea. From our transportation team, Jose Fuentes. From Robert Rojas, Ramona Cernas. From District Operations, Carlos Cifuentes. And from Socorro High School, Dolores Silva. Congratulations once again. Thirty-five years ago, in 1981, the district had 5,315 students, a little over 500 employees, and only five schools. That was a year Ronald Reagan became the U.S. president. It also was a year of medical advancements as the first combined heart-lung transplant was performed. Hip-hop was introduced, and popular artists at the time were Depeche Mode, Blondie, and Prince. Most importantly, it was the year this TMSISD employee would start her 35-year career with the district. Celebrating 35 years of service in SISD from Sierra Vista Elementary School, Yolanda Rangel. Congratulations once again on your amazing career. That concludes our recognitions for the evening. Thank you.
Okay, let's go down to item number six. Consider approval of Generation Texas Month Proclamation, November 2016. Ms. McCabe.
President Gondra, there we go. Dr. Espinosa and members of the board, my name is Tammy McCabe, Director of Guidance and Counseling, and I'm here this evening to present three students that are going to read you the proclamation for Generation Texas Week. And the Texas Education Code 29.91 requires each middle, junior, and high school to provide students with information about higher education options. The Texas Higher Education Board has a week that is called Generation Texas Week statewide. It is focused on creating a culture of college and career readiness that leads to the most successful generation in Texas history. This year, Generation Texas Month is in the month of November, and we have three students here that will be reading the proclamation to you. We have Kenny Flores, who is a junior at Americas High School, Ileana Beltran, who is a seventh grader at Ernesto Cerna School, and Linnell McBride, who is a second grader at John Drugan School.
Whereas Texas Education Code Chapter 29.911 requires each middle school, junior high school, and high school to provide students with information about higher education education options. Whereas the mission of Socorro Independent School District is to maximize our children's academic, artistic, athletic, and social skills. Whereas the mission of Socorro Independent School Guidance and Counseling Program is to provide a comprehensive developmental guidance and counseling program that will maximize the academic, personal, social, and career competencies of all students so that they may realize personal post-secondary goals.
Whereas Socorro students who attend institutions of higher education attain a wide range of personal, financial, and other lifelong benefits.
Whereas the demand for graduates of higher education globally has increased and will continue to grow. Whereas the counselors, faculty, and staff of Socorro Independent School District campuses realize the importance of educating students on higher education, including higher education options, admissions requirements, availability of financial aid, and financial aid requirements. Therefore, we do hereby proclaim November 2016 as Generation Texas Month.
Board accept the proclamation.
Motion to approve.
Second.
We have a motion made by Mrs. Nagara, second by Mrs. Rodriguez. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Opposed? Motion carries. Thank you.
Thank you.
Item B, consider approval of Red Ribbon Week proclamation October 24th to the 28th, 2016. Ms. McKeven.
Yes. Thank you again. The students are going to read to you the proclamation for Red Ribbon Week. Red Ribbon Week is the largest and oldest drug prevention campaign nationwide. The campaign is a response to the 1985 death of DEA agent Kiki Camarena, who was abducted and murdered by drug traffickers in Mexico. During Red Ribbon Week, Socorro ISD recognizes Kiki Camarena and assists students in taking a stance against drug abuse and instead living a healthy lifestyle. Each year, we request the SISD board to approve the proclamation to honor our students and community in striving for a safe, drug-free, and healthy lifestyle. And the students will now read the proclamation.
Whereas the Socorro Independent School District values the health and safety of all our students and our community, and whereas substance abuse, particularly damaging to one of our most valuable resources, our children, and
whereas it is the goal of Red Ribbon Week and the Socorro Independent School District to involve families, schools, businesses, law enforcement agencies, and service organizations in all aspects of this campaign, and establish an atmosphere that supports awareness, education, and ongoing initiatives to prevent illegal drug use. And whereas Red Ribbon Week is celebrated in honor of Enrique Kiki Camarena, a federal drug enforcement agent who was killed while investigating a drug cartel. And
whereas Red Ribbon Week campaign theme promotes family and individual responsibilities for living healthy, drug-free lifestyles, and there are many activities planned during the Red Ribbon Week campaign and campuses throughout Socorro ISD. Now, therefore, be it resolved that Socorro Independent School District Board of Trustees do hereby proclaim October 24th to October 28th, 2016 as Red Ribbon Week, and encourage students, parents, employees, and our community to participate in drug prevention education activities and demonstrate that our school district and community are committed to being drug-free.
Again, we ask the board to accept the proclamation.
A motion has been made by Mr. Guerra, seconded by Ms. Rodriguez. Any further discussion? All those in favor? Aye. Opposed? Motion carries. Thank you so much. Okay, let's move on to item number 7, open forum. We do have some individuals that did sign up. We greatly appreciate those individuals who have requested to speak to the board during open forum or in regards to a specific agenda item. We are bound by certain time constraints in order to cover all items on the agenda, and therefore must limit presentations to 5 minutes. Please respect the rights of others in your presentation. By law, the board cannot take action upon or discuss any item which is not posted on tonight's agenda, but will give all presentations our serious consideration. Thank you. Let's proceed with open forum. Laura Lopez.
Good afternoon. My name is Laura Lopez. I'm here, I'm a parent of two students at John Druin School. Last month, we received a proposal for rebounding to change the boundaries. We as parents, we don't like this proposal because it will affect us in several ways. For our students, we'll be we consider that they will be affected emotionally because we are living there. Most of the neighborhood was since 2014, so all our kids are, most of them, they went to John Druin. So this will be have like a huge impact on them. So that's why we would like to talk about it, that we didn't like this proposal and we would like to stop it before it keeps going. And that's what I'm here for. And I understand that there will be an increment according what you have on the neighborhood, that they're gonna build more houses. But we would like to suggest for this increment that maybe the new students can go to the proposal to the other school. We already have our children, they have their roots, okay? They've been there since kindergarten, they're in fifth grade, sixth grade, and that will affect them a lot. And same for us as parents. So we would like to your help on this situation, and we're suggesting, because we understand that we will have more houses built, that the new areas can go to your proposal because they won't be affected. For them, it's new. Okay, for us, we'll be in there for a while. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ms. Lopez.
Yes.
We really can't talk about it, Ms. Lopez, but we will take your consideration. We will take it under consideration, Ms. Lopez.
Okay.
And hopefully one of our assistant superintendents can call you in, and hopefully we can set up a meeting to talk to you and the parents.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you,
Ms. Lopez.
President Gandra, if I may.
Yes, sir.
Just to let everyone know that there is a scheduled meeting. There is a scheduled meeting with the Druid community coming up in the near future. What day? Tuesday. October 25th at John Drugan. Okay? Thank you.
Okay, next we have Ms. Lynn Hardeman.
If you were paying attention, you know I've been here 25 years and I still get nervous doing this. So I think back in the old days when I was in high school and my speech teacher said, to imagine your audience with no clothes on. So that's what I'm doing tonight. So if I start laughing, you know why.
If she starts laughing, she's thinking of you, Gary.
Oh.
I've been involved with literary anthology for 25 years. After Holly Braden, one of the founders of this, retired, I was district coordinator for 7 years before the position was moved to the district service center. Previously, the literary anthology coordinators received two stipends, one to prepare for the contest and one to publish the book. Last year, with no input of any kind from the literary anthology coordinators, one stipend was eliminated, the workload combined, and the compensation reduced by $300. I'm curious where the endless opportunities for the teachers are in this situation. We work on the only adjudicated anthology in Texas, and it's been featured in the National Education Association magazine. We provide an excellent avenue for growth mindset. Creativity and literacy skills are honed and rewarded, but the coordinator's compensation was reduced by $300. Why? No warning was given. I was unaware until my paycheck in May. At the first literary anthology meeting in September, I questioned the literary anthology district coordinators and was referred to human resources. I emailed human resources on September 21st and again on September 29th and have received no response. The lack of transparency in a district that shines in so many ways really grieves me. So SISD can maintain highly qualified faculty that care to lead, inspire, and innovate. Those directly affecting the students should be treated with more respect and dignity than cutting the stipends after the work had been begun and with no knowledge that this would occur. Okay, you have your clothes back on.
Ms. Herman, thank you so much. Next is Jesus de Avila.
By the way, I'm not picturing anybody naked today. It's a little awkward. The reason I'm here is, will we all agree that this is the best district in El Paso by a round of applause? I completely agree. We have an amazing district that's growing. We have an amazing principal at John Drugan, and that's the reason I'm here. Mr. Garcia was just recognized 25 years. So. But I know Ms. Lopez spoke briefly about the districting being looked at possibly for adjustment. And I know we're not going to vote or act upon that right now. But I'm here to let as many people know that I was asked to be here 5 years ago. The way I was asked to be here was on the first day of kindergarten with my daughter. We all went into that room and we sat in those tiny chairs. The kids fit perfect and the adults didn't quite fit. And eventually we fit. And they told us, be part of your school, be part of the educational system, and you can make your school great. We did that. We became part of John Drugen, and it's a great school. And now they're talking about redistricting, changing those boundaries. But in that meeting, first day of school of kindergarten, they said, take care of your school, fight for your school. We're here to fight for our school. So we're excited that the district is growing. We're looking at the different numbers as percentages, where if we're moved to this school and that school, 20% will be affected here, 10% will be affected there. The largest margin is about 20% that they're saying will be affected. Guess what? These aren't percentages. These are kids. So as we look at the website from the school district, it says our mission is to have 100% graduate. How about taking the percent out and having every child graduate? So we don't want our children affected by whatever percentages, so we can maximize building space or square footage. We want to leave our school that we help build the way it is because it's working, and model other schools from John Drugen because it's an amazing school. So we ask you to consider this as the district grows, to keep John Drugen the way it is and keep it functioning. And in return, as the district grows, all the parents will remember that when we need to vote to make this district bigger and fund bigger projects and fund other schools, rather than taking a school that works perfect, calling these kids a percentage, and affecting their education, these families, by redrawing districts. Thank you.
Mr. Davila, thank you so much for your presentation. Okay, let's go down to item 8, district reports, facility reports, Mr. Iington.
Good evening, President Gondola, Dr. Espinosa, members of the board. My report will begin on page 14. Facility committee met earlier this month to review it. Prior to me getting into the report, if you recall, last month we brought to you a final construction contract amount on Pebble Hills with a deductive change order on the construction portion of it. We have since gone back and, as we do in all the projects, looked at the other pieces that are put together on that. And we have reviewed some of the construction change order requests throughout the project, and working with my staff, the architect, Park Hill Smith & Cooper, and the contractor, construction manager, Buford Thompson, we have come up with some more savings dealing with the architectural firm. These savings I presented to the facility board range anywhere from credits on plumbing items, water softeners, fume hoods that were not specified, credits on some canopy, where we kind of split the difference between the four entities to pay for it. Credits for redoing a depressed slab, which we charged back totally 100% to the architect, and some metal doors and stuff. Those credits that I basically enumerated, one, two, three, four, five, six of them, were actually credited from their invoices once they billed us architectural fees. That number comes to a little over $21,000 that we credited their fees to. The second set of numbers is a little bit higher than that. and they had to do with some items that we felt like were not properly designed, were left off, and that had to do with some membrane flashing on our EFAS panels, or the exterior finish of our parapet walls. EFAS is just a type of material, but it's a finished stucco. And we also provided during early on in the stage, this was a biggie to me, was we like to do equity amongst everything when we did our last three high schools. And so we used El Dorado floor plan or layout of their athletic facility. We gave them that drawing. We gave them a drawing of East Lake, which was similar to El Dorado. And then we were thinking that Pebble Hills was going to be similar to all those two. They left out the urinals. And so we made them pay for providing urinals in that restroom that they left out. That was $33,000. We also had some credits on the parapet wall, or the wall, if you recall what the building looks like, the exterior wall above the auditorium was going to have some nice tile work on it, but those tiles were going to weigh anywhere from 70 to 80 pounds. Once we questioned that, it wasn't designed properly. They had to come in there and reinforce it. We said, no, I don't want to put them up there. So we did a stucco finish up there. We used those tiles inside the building as a wainscot, and we don't have wainscot, meaning that it went up so high on the wall. And then the last one, they failed to specify a shade cloth for our greenhouse in our building. And same thing, same greenhouse that we spec'd on East Lake. Those items added up to, and I've got a check in my office that if the board agrees tonight, or it's not made out to me, $63,283.50, for a total of $84,298.50 that we have reduced their fees. And so those are some of the things that we have are continually look at. We have not totally paid them off. There could be some more. We had a meeting today. We went over a few issues that were still pending on the site, but I wanted to bring that as a follow-up that I presented to the facility committee back on October the 3rd. I can give you a detailed report if you want in your Friday package. I'm sure you'll let Dr. Espinosa how do you want me to handle that. But let's move on to the actual facility report. If I can get this thing to work. Okay, the first ones are the football fields. The lighting of the football fields bleachers at America's El Dorado and Montwood High School. We have completed those projects. They're in the warranty stages, or the punch-out, close-out stages. We finally received the certificate of occupancy from America's High School, and we will be coming up with a deductive change order after we review all the construction accounting and CCRs on that project. The next project is our transportation facility next to us. You can see that it has come a long way. We should take substantial completion of that project by the end of this week, hopefully the first part of next week. These are a couple of pictures. You can see the guard rail on the, I guess, the far south side of the building or east side of the building, and then the new gates at the where it ties into the existing parking lot on the transportation facility. We also will have some savings on that, and we will be bringing those forward once we close that project out. The Aquatic Center, we finally have got our contract from Jordan Foster Construction. We'll issue our notice to proceed, and that work will begin on the exterior and will continue on the interior after the season is down and we can start that interior pool. America's High School Courtroom. A couple of the board members has been asking me about this. We are doing this as a facility and plan an in-house project. The courtroom, if you don't, well, we got the pictures first. Okay, that shows that we've gutted the room and that we have started putting up some stud walls. But the room actually goes on the first floor where it's kind of highlighted in red in that pod area. And then these are the plans. It'll be both the courtroom layout and the legislative layout. So they'll be able to move the furniture to adjust each one. We should have this project complete by December the 1st or before we come back after the New Year's. But like I said, we're doing this internally with our own staff, and they are remarkable in some of their millwork and stuff that they do, and I think this will be a very nice project once it's completed. And I believe that completes my construction report, facility report.
Any questions for Mr. Arrington? Thank you, Mr. Arrington.
Thank you.
Let's go to item B, grant reports. Ms. Darnell.
Good evening, President Gondita, Dr. Espinosa, and members of the board. For our grants update this month, on our Project SMART grant, we are doing training for the LEGO robotics in preparation for Robocom. And then all of our DODEA reports, our annual reports are required this month in October. So we're getting those finished up. They're due at the end of the month. And then for the APIN grant, we have an audit this month that will be the last couple weeks. So that will be going on soon. And we've also got student ambassadors program training scheduled for our student-to-student program. And I was thinking about these four grants today. These are all, collectively, those four grants equal $5 million that our district has received in the past couple years. And that's all enabled by Impact Aid. So I mentioned the Impact Aid at the bottom because to be eligible to apply for those grants, we have to complete the Impact Aid. And so that's a big part of the reason why we do that every year. And out of that $5 million goes across to about 20 schools. So we have that many military federally connected schools. Grants awaiting notification, we're down to one for a small grant for the Reaching for Excellence grant. Grants not awarded, we received news that this one, which was not a big surprise, these grants primarily went to the very small districts. In fact, all of them went to less than 5,000 students in the school district. So that wasn't a surprise, but we still had hoped. And then we did find out on Wynn Academy that we got $800,000 on that one, so that will begin rolling. And then over this last month, we submitted our last year's Impact Aid. We resubmitted an amendment to increase the numbers of students for that grant. That was submitted on September 30th. And then we wrote three small grants, two to the Fort Bliss Spouses Association for food, and for Purple Heart Elementary, we also requested some books for their library. And O'Shea Keller, the price is given five for a $5,000 grant for a circulation desk. Applications in progress, we've got this year's, the surveys did go out, and so we've got to get those all returned for this current year. And then we're also looking actively at a grant from the Texas Education Agency that will be for early college high school, an innovative academy, the next generation of early college high school, and we're looking at Options High School. We'll be meeting Friday again. They met last Friday, and that grant will range between $150,000 and $400,000. And that concludes concludes my report. Are there any questions?
Any questions for Ms. Darnell? Thank you, Ms. Darnell.
Okay, thank you.
Let's go down to item number 9, consent agenda. Is there any items that need to be pulled? Yes, sir.
Pretty much the second half, no. E1, E2, and E5, please.
Okay. Any other items?
Yes, President, the administration is pulling item 9, E7 from the agenda, and we'll bring back this item during the month of November. 9, E7.
Motion to approve consent agenda with the exception of items E1, E2, E5, and E7.
Second. Motion has been made by Mrs. Nájera, seconded by Mr. Guerra. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Item 1, E1.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Motion has been made by Mr. Rodriguez, seconded by Mrs. Nájera. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
And I abstain.
Item E2.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Item E2 has been, a motion has been made by Mrs. Rodriguez, seconded by Mrs. Nájera. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
And I abstain. I work for the college.
Okay. Item E5.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Motion has been made by Mrs. Rodriguez, seconded by Mrs. Nájera. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Okay. Let's go down to item 10, new business. Consider approval of TASB update 105 and 106. Ms. Macias. I always do that. Mrs. Macias, I'm sorry.
Thank you. President Ganda, Dr. Espinosa, members of the board, administration recommends consideration and approval of the revisions to policies TASB update 105, CLB, and TASB update 106, policy EHBAF, as presented.
Further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
Thank you.
Let's go down to item 11, executive session. This meeting is to be closed for consultation with legal counsel regarding status of litigation involving Emergency Services District Number 1 versus Socorro ISD, case number 2015-DCV1004, and possible settlement to discuss personal and real estate matters, and to consider an administrative recommendation for Director of Bilingual Education, Assistant Principals at Sierra Vista Elementary School, and Sergeant Manuel Puentes Middle School under Texas Government Code Section 551.071, 551.072, and 551.074. Time is 7:16. DCV 1004 and possible settlement.
Thank you, Board President Gondra, Dr. Espinosa. Members of the board, I gave you an update on the status of our discussions with the ESD regarding this litigation, and we recommend that you authorize us to move forward with the settlement as discussed in closed session.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Motion has been made by Mrs. Rodriguez, seconded by Mr. Guerra. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.
Thank you.
Item 12B, consider approval of administrative recommendations. Dr. Espinosa.
Yes, President Gandra and members of the board, at this time, administration recommends Ms. Karina Silva Schulte to assume all the roles and the responsibilities as the Director of Bilingual Education.
Motion. Second.
Motion has been made by Mr. Guerra, seconded by Mrs. Rodriguez. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Assistant Principals, Sierra Vista Elementary School.
Yes, President Gandra and members of the board, at this time, administration recommends Ms. Portia Jackson to assume all the roles and the responsibilities as assistant principal of Sierra Vista Elementary.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Motion has been made by Mrs. Rodriguez, seconded by Mrs. Nájera. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Item B, Sergeant Manuel Puentes Middle School.
Yes, President Gandara and members of the board, at this time, administration recommends Ms. Jessica Estrada to assume all the roles and the responsibilities as assistant principal of Manuel Puentes Middle School.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Motion has been made by Mrs. Rodriguez, seconded by Mrs. Najera. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. There be no more agenda items on tonight's agenda. This meeting is over at 8:11.